Hello, this is the Elder Scrolls Online webcast and podcast brought to you by Alith, the fun, no-pressure, social and casual ESO guild based on the European Megaserver. Welcome to episode 19 of Alith-Cast Live. Hello and welcome to the show. Say hi, everybody.
Hello.
Hello.
Good evening, everyone.
You're so professional. I didn't want to, you know.
You didn't want to break the silence. Thanks, guys. Leave me hanging. Yeah. So, with us tonight, we have Paul Etherton. Hello, mate.
Hello. I'm very well because I've now finished work for the Christmas period today.
Oh, excellent.
This is wonderful.
Me too.
Hooray!
Yay!
And also with us is Elloa.
Yeah, hello everyone.
Yeah, hello in your new apartment.
Yes, indeed. Here you can discover this is all new.
Very, very nice.
A lot of light, everything. It's warm. I don't need a scarf anymore.
Ah, cool. That's great. And introducing new to the show, it's Nate Lanxon.
Hey, how's dudes. Nice? How's Welcome. It going?
Absolutely fine, mate. It's nice to see you on the show. So, we should really, let's see, on today's show, I'll get back to you to let folk know exactly who you are, this mystery man that we have in our middle box. On today's show, quick overview, we're going to be looking at New Life Festival, Homestead, and we've got some, we've got quite a bit of guild news, actually. Should be fun. So, Nate, you're a regular presenter with Tales of Tamriel, along with Agelos and Arcania. But you've quite a resume, haven't you?
I did in the Elder Scrolls world. I have been with Alith for a couple of years. I usually lurk in the chat box, so I'm reading everything, but I'm not the world's most frequent typer. I did ESO RP for quite a while with Knight's Knight and Mariel and a few others over there. And then more recently, I've done Tales of Tamriel with Agelos and Arcanir. But that's become a little bit less regular over the last 4 or 5 months as IRL stuff has got in the way, a pesky real life of mine. Yeah, but it's good to be here. And listen, I just threw mud at 10 high elves, so I'm feeling pretty excited about life in general. Thanks to the New Life Festival.
It's so best to do with them. Yes.
Yeah.
Damn Alpha.
Spoilers, Nate. Spoilers.
Sorry, man. Yeah, there's mud, there's high elves in Elder Scrolls Online. Who knew? Who knew? Very fun.
Oh, dear. Well, it's good to see you on the show. It's nice to have, it's nice to break new people in, should I say.
Yeah, I'm in one piece. I'm in one piece right now so far. One piece.
Yeah, you haven't got to the end of the 3-hour show yet. Yeah.
No, this is true. I can't guarantee I will not break midway, but we'll see.
So, yeah, I guess we should fire it up. Let's fire it up with Elder Scrolls Online news and discussion. And New Life Festival.
Yes.
Has everybody been enjoying, New Life Festival?
Not yet. About to, potentially.
Yes, yeah. Are you going to be doing all the quests this evening?
Oh, well, I don't know. I think we'll see how we go, kind of thing. Yeah.
We need to see him discover the quest and share with us his first impression.
Yes.
So we can comment about it.
Yes. So I have done literally none of it whatsoever.
Oh, excellent.
Like, none of it. So I think you get a scroll in the Crown Store from somewhere here.
Yes, yep. You do. Yeah.
Purchase for free. Ta-da!
Congratulations.
Works exactly the same as the was it the whistle, I think, from the from the Witches Festival. It was the whistle, wasn't it? Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, works exactly the same as that.
Ah, right. So read the scroll and get a quest. Directs revelers to Breeda, a new life herald in Eastmarch. There's a small note. All are welcome to celebrate. I should find her. Okay, I should go to Eastmarch then. I think there is a way shrine over here somewhere. Oh, hello.
Nate will be back shortly. His call just dropped out.
Oh. That's unfortunate.
Cue panic in the background as our director tries and tries to remedy all the all the windows that have gone totally skew if instantly. Okay. Yes. There will be a short period of mass panic as as everything goes pear-shaped.
Is half of my screen in Nate's?
Yeah, it is. Yes. That's, yes. His windows.
That's a thing.
His windows disappeared.
Oh, goody. Right.
Oh, okay.
Ah.
Yeah, it makes everything complex.
Yeah, okay, that's better. Yeah. Welcome back, mate.
Hey.
Yeah. Hey.
Nothing went wrong. Of course it was fine. Not a problem. If you rely on a 4G connection in the middle of nowhere, you are destined for trouble.
All is fine now.
It is, yeah. Yeah, it's better than trying to get any sort of mobile phone signal down the M6 corridor. That just doesn't exist.
Yeah, well, I'm in a place in Derbyshire called Cowdale.
Right, yeah.
So that will give you some impression of how rural this is, but it has 4G. So far, it's, well, until that blip, it was going very, very well.
Right. So whereabouts are you, Paul?
Right. So this tent is definitely new.
He's meeting Breda.
Yeah, here we are.
So yeah, as with the other festival, there's a new NPC for you to go and meet, and she will give you to complete the quest once you've accepted the scroll, and she'll tell you about the new life festival and the different ways in which the different races of Tamriel celebrate new life.
That's what I find very interesting into this event, is that you have several reasons, several customs from different races and different style of quest that Paul will discover in a moment. But everything is different, and it's not huge quest, it's just a little fun moment, and so.
It is, yeah. I mean, a lot of other games just simply plaster Christmas trees and balloons and that, everything, you know, in every single city, and, you know, all the different races are doing exactly the same thing. Well, at least we've got a little bit of, we've got culture, which is good. Have you been doing a lot of, Nate, have you been?
Yeah, I'm about halfway through the New Life Festival stuff. I don't want to throw too many more spoilers out there, but as Elloa was saying, it's varied. It's a diverse collection of small things to be doing. I'm enjoying it very much.
Yeah. It is. It's very, very cool. As Paul's just been to that tent. If you hunt around that tent, which I miserably failed to do so, wondering what the hell was going on, there's actually a barrel with, is it Breda's Magnificent Mead or something like that in it?
Yeah, the one that gives you 2 times more experience that I missed as well.
Yeah.
Right. Yeah. BDR viewers will have noticed that A, I drank from it, and B, I just leveled up.
Nice.
So it works, apparently.
Excellent. I should find that as well.
Where are you now?
I'm doing it right now.
I'm in Grotwood, so this is obviously not my main. This is a Argonian Nightblade called Watched by Many, which is perhaps... Mm-hmm.
Very appropriate.
An ambitious name. and he doesn't even have any way shrines in Grotwood, so I had to find a guildie to port on. So I've ended up somewhere in Grotwood, and I'm moving towards talking to someone at the Temple of the Eight. So apparently some high elves come to Grotwood to donate some money or something, according to Reader, is that her name?
Yes. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Donate to the War Orphans. One thing I must admit, one thing that I found with this one is that this one, there's two parts to it. You can either donate money, which is the quick and dirty way of completing the quest, or you can go and kill the local wildlife to stop them encroaching upon the festivities. Yeah, there isn't that much in the way of wildlife because everyone else is killing it as well.
Yeah. I had that problem as well. I killed 5 thunderbugs with a group of 7 people. but you can do both, and you then get an achievement.
Oh, so you can donate and kill as well.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. That's what I did, actually.
Yeah. So donate first and then do the killing. And then when you do the killing, you get a separate achievement.
Cool. Right. I should be doing that. I think I've done these twice now, done the daily twice now. So
there is a lot of achievement related to those quests. The people that are achievement hunter will have a lot of fun to try to figure out what they need to do. Right. There's a very good guide that Deltia has published regarding the New Life Festival. If people feel lost and they want to be spoiled, just watch this video. It's well made. If you don't want to be spoiled, like Paul, just discover it yourself and have fun.
Where the hell are you finding all this wildlife? Is everyone asleep?
Everyone is watching, that's why.
I'm not sure that 2 wasps counts as wildlife because, you know, I found a wasp at work earlier today. That's not, you know.
Hey, we're serious. That was seriously out of season.
A December wasp.
It really was. It was very surprising to me.
I bet he was damned annoyed. Wasps are always annoyed.
There was a really sugary cupcake in a bowl on the desk of the girl that sits next to me, and a wasp just appeared and decided it wanted some of the cupcake action, which I don't blame it. No, you're right. There's not an awful lot of encroaching wildlife going on here. There's a lot of people around. So I'll probably end up killing those 2 wasps again when they respawn or something stupid.
I just found that Breeder's Magnificent Mead, and you're right, 100% boost to all experience for 2 hours. I'm glad you pointed that out, because I did not know that for the first half of this quest.
Yeah, it's pretty cool. I mean, that's all experience as well, isn't it? Because
the experience potions
just give you the usual experience potions. They're just on kills, aren't they, I believe?
No, I don't think so. I think they're for everything.
No, that's for everything. Yeah. Citric Ambrosia is for everything.
It doesn't. It doesn't boost the AP in Cyrodiil though, which is a permanent annoyance to me. But that's a topic for another day.
Maybe if they did that.
That would let people win, wouldn't it? Isn't that? Yeah. They would let you go up the lead.
People will complain.
Yeah. Yeah, that's true. That's true.
Oh, there you go. There's that achievement you talked about. War Orphans Benefactor.
You've done it?
Yeah, apparently there's loads of Horvers here, and I could have done it in 5 seconds if I'd have known this.
Horvers, That's what I meant, not Thunderbugs. Horvers is what they were.
Yeah.
If you need porting anywhere, let me know, because I'm jumping around Tamriel doing these things as well.
You're in game. Okay, yeah. That's helpful.
Excellent.
Yeah, I've got a character with a lot more way shrines, but I thought it was fun to do it on this character.
Do you want me to group you and you can just port to wherever I am, or anywhere you need to be?
That might be helpful.
Okay.
Yeah, I mean, the quests are not huge distances away from actually getting around Tamriel, if you know how to use the little ships that are the docks on the major starting points. But yeah, they're good to discover. What have you been doing, Elloa, in the festival? Have you?
Oh yeah, I've played with a friend and we did all the quests several times. It was very fun, especially with certain item that Paul will discover later. So no spoiler. What I think is that you have a lot of nice new animation that has been introduced with those quests, and a lot of little items that you can earn that are funny. And the reward system is kind of nice because it's nothing that you really need, but it's little things that make your time more enjoyable when you can, you know, being silly with your character, mess around and such. It's very nice.
Yeah, I must admit, I mean, Paul's going to get to these, but there are some items that, the new animations that you wish you could get as a memento permanently.
Mm-hmm. But sort of
right. Restricted to the new Life Festival, which is, we'll find out about those in a tick.
I'm going to confess that the first quest was a little underwhelming.
They're not all as good as the other. I mean, there's some that are introducing new mechanics and they are kind of fun, but what's nice too is to know a little bit about the story and to put yourself in the role, you know? You're doing some festival from different races, and Altmers are a bit boring in general anyway. What do you think?
It's just Altmers. Festival Grog, that sounds entertaining. I feel like I should be a Nord right now. That would be more appropriate for that.
The Nord one is very good, indeed. I hope you will have it.
Got Argonians now.
Oh, the Argonian one.
The Argonian one.
Right. Yes.
You remember?
That one.
I've literally never fished in this game. I'm not going to start now. Slippery slope, that is.
you got to fish. Unfortunately.
You have to. You're forced to. Yeah. So for the person that do not like to fish, the Argonian celebration is not the funniest one. But it's because the Argonian are a nice society. What they are doing on New Year's is to gather food to offer to the person that needs it. So they are doing charity, which is very good.
I am an Argonian, so I should probably...
you should be proud of your own culture.
You should be port on you, Nate. You seem like in a more helpful place.
Mm-hmm. I am in... where am I? Dishan, I think. No, I'm not.
No, you're not. You're in Shadowfen.
Hismir. I mean, I'm near Hismir, I think.
It's just kind of where I'm trying to go. So, yeah.
Perfect timing.
Yeah, the fishing spots for the for the quest are sort of southeast. Yeah.
Yeah. Southeast. I've got northern kind of way shrines, it seems.
I love me some Argonians.
Argonians are very cool looking, must be admitted. I like the fin that my character has. It's really cool.
They have some very very good quests as well, does the Argonians. Great characters, especially in the newer dungeons as well. One of the characters in that is excellent.
I like how they scale.
Oh.
Sorry.
Nice, great.
That's really bad.
That's the quality that we're going to get this episode, is it?
That's right.
That would be the highlight.
Oh, dear me. So we should mention moving on. on the completion of every quest, you get a new life gift box, which contains, and I'm reading this verbatim from the website, an assortment of new life festival themed goodies. It will always contain a random crafting material, provisioning
ingredients. I got one of those. Yeah,
or a health glyph. A consumable version of a new life themed memento. Mm-hmm. Did you get a memento from that last one that you did?
Yeah, check that out because it's funny.
Where would it be consumable?
It's in consumable and it's like... Nice.
Is this the one?
Probably, I cannot read it.
Okay. Yeah, that'll be it.
Festival.
Yeah, yeah. And use it. Go. Do it.
Oh, you're getting drunk first and then you're going to do the juggling.
Oh, yeah. Drunk knife juggling.
The best sort of juggling. There you go. So these, I believe, did we see these first in Hugh's Bane? There was an awful lot of NPCs doing random things, weren't there, in Hugh's Bane when that was introduced? juggling and
right.
which we will see later on.
I'm not quite sure what the purpose of the being really drunk is. Oh, no, I've got a wisp problem here.
Oh, yes, the wisps. I hate wisps.
You hate what?
I hate wisps. What's the wisps and wasps? They're just irritating.
Whispers?
What about whispers?
I don't mind whispers. Yeah. But so, yeah, and you get a skin changer style item, which is Wolfbane incense. Now, I'm presuming when we get out, when the New Life Festival ends, that we're not going to be seeing Wolfbane incense, are we? Does anybody recall whether you've been able to get, you know, the style item for the new, for the motif?
Does that right. Yeah. Well, the Hollowjack marble things you can't get now, but everyone has loads of them because they're just stupidly common.
So of course, be rare in Julie. So
can you use them? Can you use crown mimic stones to do non-crown? Can you? You can just craft anything with those kinds.
Yes.
Of
yeah.
Yes.
So you could. Yeah. You could buy those and use those, I guess.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Exactly. I think that's the point to make you buy those.
Yeah. Yeah. It's a very good way of getting.
This would be the right place because there's lots of people fishing here. New life.
That's probably the right place then.
Hold slope bait. What do I need?
I think I need worm.
You need gut, I think, or gut or no gut. It's for C.
I've literally never fished in this game ever.
Worm is for C, so it's gut. No, not sure enough. Maybe someone in the chat know. I'll remember.
Yeah, go on, chat.
Help us.
Lake, help.
Oh look, I got the thing. Hooray!
Oh, you got the thing. Nice.
I did. Cool. I got one of the things. I got a black marsh cucumber, which...
Black marsh cucumber, you need more than that, yeah.
So is it, with the long history of fishing in Aliths, Nate, have you been fishing?
I have been fishing, but I am nowhere near getting the Master Angler achievement. That requires a great deal of patience, which I do not have. So far, fishing eludes me.
Yes, I must admit.
Oh, what? No. Did I time it wrong or something? That's really annoying. Oh, the thing ran out. What?
Run out.
The circle got empty after.
Yeah, just as I was about to get a thing. Yeah, there was a time when so many people in Aliths were either Swedish or fishers or both. I used to joke that we were a Swedish fishing guild. Which was actually really accurate at the time.
I'd love to do more of it, to be honest. I'd love to do more. Like, Agelis and the guys on the US server will have their sort of drunken fishing nights, which we never did on. We had an EU guild for a while, and we never actually did it. And that seemed like a missed opportunity to get some of those achievements and get some of that fish. So
I know there was a danger fishing event back in the day when the guild went fishing in Cyrodiil.
Hmm. Oh, that would be fine with me. I mean, I spend more than half my time in-game in Cyrodiil, so I think I'm not sure what my level is, but I think it's about 30 or so. So it's not usually a problem if anyone ambushes me. I can usually take care of them.
I just keep getting the Black Marsh Cucumber over and over again. That's no good.
Oh, you'll get them eventually. Have you got any of the... What do you need to get now?
It doesn't take so much time.
Yeah.
Even with a lot of people around. Also, in addition, when you have a lot of people around, you have more chance to get the correct fish.
That's right. Yeah. Yeah, that's one of them.
That's the second time that I've got a thing and then it's vanished before I've grabbed it because the thing's run out. So that's kind of...
You need the fishing add-on.
Yeah.
No.
No.
No add-on is needed.
I'm only fishing right now because of more extreme peer pressure than usual. What? Oh, go away. There's a dolmen there. We should do the dolmen.
I'm coming to you now to do some fishing.
Step away from the dolmen. Those are not fish.
They're really not, but they are aggroed.
I'll come and find you. We'll take down that dolmen.
So
can I just use a lightning staff to just electrocute all the water? That feels much more efficient.
We've tried that. It doesn't work, unfortunately.
Oh, that breaks my immersion, that does.
Meteor doesn't work. You can't dynamite the fish either.
Yeah.
So in addition to the skin changer item, the consumable and the crafting material, you will also receive one of the following, which is a chapter of the skin change motif. Let's have a see. Have we a picture of that? A picture of that will appear on the screen at some point in the festivities, which is actually quite good. There we go. I mean, that picture is that just the heavy? I believe that's just the heavy, isn't it?
Come on.
So you get, you will get a motif chapter, a new life recipe of either green, blue, or gold. I must admit, I've had loads and loads of blues. I haven't had a gold yet. And a special new life collectible. So that's one of the four. I haven't had it.
I must have got this hat.
Ooh, right. So you've got...
Thanks. That's the one I got.
I've had the hat. I've had the one of the hats and I've one of the and the costume up to now. So the drops are pretty good. Have you guys had any of the goodies?
Not to me yet.
No. Hello, have you got your bath towel yet? Oh.
Yes, I did. I got my bath towel.
Bath towel?
Yeah,
something here. <You'll>...
Yeah, you. I mean, ZeniMax is quite generous with the rewards you receive easily, hats and costume and stuff. So the RNG is good, or maybe I had been just lucky. I'm very lucky lately, so that might be it. So I don't know.
I think it's actually reasonably.
Oh, I did it! I don't have to fish anymore.
Excellent.
Right.
Congrats.
I feel like Argonians should fish with their claws. That would be much better.
True, but maybe it's difficult to set up that.
Yeah.
Or you could have a spear instead of a fishing rod. That could be cool.
Yeah, I miss the spear. I haven't had spears since Morrowind. I suppose Templars have sort of got spears, kind of, but...
Yeah, not really. It's spell spear. Want a real spear.
Yes, exactly.
That's a weapon that will be nicely added in the game.
It's not clear what gap it would sort of fill, what it would do.
It will be nice. It will be a ranged melee weapon. So you could use it as a ranged and as melee weapon. We are totally out of subject right now. But why not?
Really? Hello.
Run like the wind. Oh, yeah, I've got a wisp problem again.
I've got a rubbish pound. My guar has no stamina whatsoever. So if anybody sneezes on him, I fall off.
So, yeah, there's... Once you've completed I should have counted before. Several quests. 1, 2, 9. Yeah. Once you've completed all 9 quests for Braider, which we are going to do over the course of the show, you receive a special new die, which is a shade blue New Life Cerulean. And the New Life Celebrant achievement. If you get all of the related achievements, you get the Magnanimous title as well. And obviously, Braider's Magnificent Mead, which is located in a keg near Braider, which I must have walked past about a dozen times. I've seen it. I had to Google it to find out how you got it. You get double XP for 2 hours. And that can be reused and reused as required. So, of course, the festival goes on until January the 4th. 3 o'clock in the afternoon, UK time, which is strange as to why it should be 3 o'clock in the afternoon. But hey.
It'll be midnight somewhere.
Yes. Yeah. Yeah, it's probably midnight Eastern or something like that.
Here we are. Just, you know, have to.
Because it's there.
Because it's there and I don't have it.
Oh, yeah.
I haven't played this all too long.
I cannot refrain myself. I need a sky shard.
Right. Okie dokie. So I have to talk to this woman.
Yes.
Yeah. And you've been a nice Agronian this year.
Okay, and I have to go back to Braden now. And there's a way shrine over here, I think.
So, you know, these fishing quests, can you get all three of the items you need, the fish, from the same area? Or do you have to go to the different markers on the quest on the map?
No, I stayed in the same circle and I eventually got all of them.
Yeah, because I'm running out of bait.
You're running out? How are you running out of bait?
Because I get rid of it because I never normally fish.
Okay. Well, it doesn't.
You don't have a crafting bag.
No, that's the thing. I do now, so I don't get rid of them anymore. But for some reason, I've got into the habit of just getting rid of them.
Yeah,
it's a mistake I'm deeply and deeply ashamed of.
I used to get rid of them because I'm not interested in fishing, and I used to give them to fishing friends or sell them. But when crafting bags came in, their value dropped because everyone suddenly had billions of them. And it was more faff to get rid of them than to keep them. It's just easier to keep them.
It's true, yeah.
It's the only reason I've got hundreds of them.
Black marsh cucumber, get in my satchel. Excellent. Everything's coming up, Nate.
Nobody wants to hear about the cucumber in your satchel.
Jeff. Moving on. So, of course, at the moment, in the Crown Star, I think it was today it dropped into the Crown Star, is the elk mount.
I bought it.
Yes, I haven't logged in today, so I'm damn sure I'm going to buy that one.
It's 4,500 crowns.
I don't have that anymore.
You don't have 4,500 crowns anymore?
No. Give me crowns.
Got the elk.
100 crowns.
No.
It is a magnificent beast. It is a magnificent beast. I am pleased to own this elk. It's my new friend. We've been on an amazing set of adventures together already. It's been a good 2 hours.
A good 2 hours.
Yeah, he's stood back. He's watched me fish a cucumber out of a lake. And you can tell he's smiling. Internally and externally, he is smiling. Histmuck Blobfin, excellent. All three. And I put all three of those successes down to my ownership of this elk. It's just been a fantastic evening in Shadowfen with my elk.
I'd like to point out that I was successful without an elk.
Yeah, but the feeling of success is greater with an elk watching your every movement, both in Tamriel and in real life. I can promise you.
I'm pretty sure that a chubloon is better. That's what I need. But I need to crack crates for that.
The damn chubloon would just eat your fish.
That is true. That is true. But it would maybe help fish. Or it would do all the fishing so I didn't have to. That would solve the problem.
But can you dry your fish out on its antlers? Because that's what I've been doing with my elk. In my head, there's no emote yet for that.
Fish drying mechanic. Yeah.
Yeah, that'll be in the Crown Store come February. Mark my words. Slash dry fish.
Actually, something to dry fish on. That actually gives us quite a nice segue into our second part of because it's going to take a while to do all these nine quests, so we're not going to sort of.
No, don't mind me, folks.
you carry on doing. Which, if you let us know, have you been back to Brady yet?
Yes, I've now got to throw some mud at some elves, which sounds good to me, frankly. Mm-hmm.
Excellent thing to be doing, definitely.
Be careful not to do it to a guard, because if you do it to a guard, it will give you a bounty. As I learnt earlier today.
Good.
Which logic dictates it would. It's just somehow it lets you do it, so you assume that's fine.
It lets you do it without warning you that it's going to be a bounty, and then you get the famous, right, that's you with a bounty then. There you go. Yeah, okay. I threw mud balls at about five or six guards before I realised that I'd got quite a... It was mounting up. So, yeah, segue, yes, into... which we covered a little bit in the last show where we were... what we were looking excited about, which was for Homestead. Are we excited about Homestead?
Hell yes.
Oh yes.
Hell yes.
Yes. Yeah.
Absolutely. Do you want to know the particular bit that I'm most excited about?
Fish drying rack.
Nope. No. I'm excited about that already. I refer you to 5 minutes ago. I'm already deeply excited about drying fish. No, real books on real bookshelves.
Oh, okay, that excites me.
Yes.
That excites me.
Yeah, that's nice.
Give me that one.
Yeah, I mean, color me excited for real books on a real bookshelf. I mean, that is excitement. It was my birthday last week, and I was not as excited then as I was when I heard about
Happy
real
books. Happy birthday.
Thank you very much. Which one of the books, this is ironic actually, one of the books that I did get actually bought on my actual birthday was the Volume 3 Arcane Skyrim book. The one that Bethesda prints.
Oh, yes.
Yep. The real ones. Which I brought up here to my family's house for Christmas to read. So clearly it really is all about books for me this year.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. What's nice is that the book that you have already find will be, it's retroactive. Yeah. So you do not need to hunt them again if you have already one or two or three or four characters with the Mage Guild completed and all the books. It will be usable in your house. So it's pretty good. I really like the fact that ZeniMax is giving a purpose to every activity in the game that you can use in your house. So if you're really into housing, you will have a good reason to go in dungeons. You will have a good reason to do your fighter's guild or your mage guilds. You will have a good reason to craft or to purchase things in the luxury merchant. So gain gold, etc. Do achievements, because you will have a lot of furniture with achievements. So it's really good.
Mm. It is, yeah. I mean, I remember it. Was it two episodes ago where we did the state of the game discussion? And there was one thing that really was mentioned was that bookshelves, where you could put your books that you had discovered. And lo and behold... We should really do the lottery numbers, because we've predicted that really, really well.
Mm. Yeah. We did, I mean, quite a few months ago, we had Rich Lambert on Tales, and one of the things that we suggested after we'd finished recording was narrated in-game books, so you can, like, listen to the book being read to you while you're going about the game. And that, to me, would be... It's such an amazing bonus to the game to be able to do that. I mean, that is, you know, we'd pay for that. And they have talked about it, apparently. How seriously, we don't know, but he did say that they had talked about maybe doing that for some books.
Yeah, I mean Bethesda have done that in Fallout 4 with the holotapes that you can pick up through Fallout 4. You just whack them in your Pip-Boy and it plays them out. They're very, very short. They're nothing in the sort of realms of the books that you find in Tamriel, but that really, really would be, I mean, can you imagine a nice radio presenter's voice?
Yeah.
Or Argonian, a boring
just
outlet.
Any voice would be great. Any voice would be great. I mean, they did it in Bioshock as well, quite effectively, and a lot of games have these kind of, you know, these tapes, you know, 1 minute tapes, but to have that done with lore books would be fantastic for immersion, particularly if you're sitting in your house having it read to you as well. That'd be That'd be fantastic.
It really would. Yeah. Mm.
That'd give me some ideas of video. Nice. Or a softly spoken stream.
Yes. Yeah. Yeah.
So, I'll sit in my house reading stories to people.
You could see it being an assistant as well that you paid for. You know, you have an assistant who you summon to your homestead, your house, who comes around and reads to you from your bookshelf while you, you know, slash sleep in your bed. I mean, nice. Talk about geeking out. It would be, that'd be worth paying for.
This is, yeah, absolutely. I mean, which is one thing we said before, which was the possibilities for Homestead are absolutely, I mean, they're endless.
Yeah.
Given the lore and the history of Tamriel compared to other games.
Definitely.
So, I mean, talking about homes, you're going to be able to pick from nearly 40, I believe, unique homes. There's a tutorial quest, naturally. And your first home, which is free, is going to be a room at the local inn, appropriately, which... All the Tamriel games, you've been able to rent an inn, a room at an inn. And then we've got additional homes, which, according to the blurb, range from a cozy tree home in Greenshade, which, yeah, I'm not going to be getting a tree home in Greenshade because I can never find my way around that place, I must admit. To a charming bijou villa in Malabaltar, all the way up to a manor estate in the Rift.
But can I be a Telvanni wizard and live in a giant mushroom house?
Probably.
This is an important thing to me.
Maybe it will come in a cron store later.
Yeah. Alongside Dwemer housing, your own dungeon, your own Dwemer delve. Could you imagine?
I think that's a lot of people will pay for that.
Yeah.
Maybe even me.
Yeah, me too. Me too.
So, I mean, the homes, they're all styled after the game's playable races. You can actually get them in furnished or unfurnished. So if you're lazy like me, you can save up and buy them ready furnished. Are obviously unfurnished, where you craft all your stuff, you collect all your stuff, and the editor, I believe, is very, very robust.
Yes,
as well.
They've shown in a live stream, you can rotate, you have a little bowl like that, and you can put it there and there and there and there. On the roof, wherever you want, which will allow players, if they are smart, to be very creative. Like it worked in Wildstar, where you could really recreate different objects from existing objects.
Oh, by combining them, yeah.
Yes. The only thing you cannot do is rescale. So that reduced the possibilities. But it will still be allow you to make, I don't know, you can make yourself stairs in books, for instance, or, you know, that kind of funny stuff.
It's just that bowl's never going to be a hot tub or anything like that.
No, you cannot do that. But you could build, tower pile of dirty bowl. Because you make your house messy.
Yeah, that sounds quite appropriate for me, actually. That's just why we bought a dishwasher.
Nice, congratulations.
We appear to have lost Nate again.
Derbyshire is having connection problems again.
Yeah.
So let's have a see. The only exception to the races, the race styles of houses, I believe, is the imperial styled homes, which means that if you want an imperial style home, you have to buy the imperial edition of ESO, which is, or the digital imperial edition upgrade, which is 2,100 crowns, I believe, in the crown store. And welcome back, sir.
Thank you. Sorry.
That's okay. I think you're actually doing quite well for a mobile phone connection. I'm really impressed.
Yeah, it's 4G. It's all right. Two dropouts in an hour, I suppose, given how rural a place I'm sitting in is not too bad. I'm convinced it's because I said the words Dwemer housing and it just couldn't take it. The excitement was too much for this limited bandwidth.
I'm banking on it being, if you went to the bottom of the tower, the 4G tower close by, I reckon there's a cow in that field with an itch.
There's a cow in that field going, oh my God, Dwemer housing.
Yes.
Let me move in. Sorry. God, what is wrong with me? It's because I had a glass of wine before the show. Anyway.
I'm impressed. They're far worse than my jokes.
There is very little evidence for this so far.
Very little evidence.
Yeah, we were saying the styles of homes. The only one that's an exception is the Imperial, which requires you to have the Imperial Edition upgrade.
Yeah.
So, I must admit, I got it when I subscribed, and sorry, when I actually bought the game, I got the Imperial Edition. And with the wonderful ability to turn any armor into Imperial armor, which I've never done. Never done, but if it means I can get an Imperial house, so be it. That's not too bad.
You don't have Imperial alts, do you, Chris?
I don't think I have. I've made them, but I've never actually been able to make an attractive Imperial.
Oh, you need to see my main.
Yeah, you should look at Misa. Misa is appealing. Appealing.
Appealing.
Yeah.
Is that as good as it gets? Appealing.
It's as good as I can get politely.
Oh, dear.
And politely, what does it give? Sorry.
So, Paul, which one are you up to at the moment?
So I have just performed, apparently juggling some flaming torches. I enjoyed throwing mud at elves. That was the best one so far.
Oh, it's very fun when you do it with a friend, and then you purchase each other and you throw a mud ball at each other, and then you're all dirty. And have you observed the animation that your character is doing?
Yes, it's great. And I like the fact that you can mud ball other players as well, not just NPCs. That was good.
Mm-hmm.
Mm. I'm literally right behind you, by the way. I've been watching everything you've been doing.
So I see.
Uh-huh.
This is the Imperial, as discussed. Yes, you've got a very Bretonish sort of thing going on, though.
Mm.
A Brimperial. So you're doing the... Told you the joke's just got steadily worse. You're doing the Castle Charm Challenge, I believe, at the moment.
Yes.
Correct.
Yes. Where you have to go and entertain everyone in the... over at... Where are you at the moment?
I'm going to juggle 9.
Alker Castle.
Yes. Yeah.
Forming the throne room. Do you think they'll appreciate me throwing knives around in the throne room?
I'm about to find out, because I'm just about to do the very same thing. Let's see. Let's see.
So while you two are throwing knives at people, juggling knives in the throne room, I reckon we should do our first giveaway of the evening.
Indeed, you should.
So, I believe you guys have words
for
the giveaway.
Excellent. Indeed, so, guys, you have the possibility to earn 20,000
20,000 crowns.
No. Oh, you cannot purchase 5 elk. I'm sorry. Just 20,000 gold, which is amazing because you will be able to save for your super manor and castle in housing. So it's just the right time to earn this. And for that, you need to give the name of the mount that is currently sold in limited edition right now.
Right.
Except I think it has been possibly mentioned on this show at some
has
point.
It's possibly been mentioned. Yes, it has. And it has to be spelt correctly. And they're off. It doesn't have a red nose.
Doesn't have a red nose, eh?
Does not have a red nose. No.
Where am I? I've forgotten which region I'm in. This is not going well. No. What's it called?
Where Alcair Castle
is. Lenumbra! Yeah, no, not...
Ah.
Where's Alcair Castle? I guessed right the first time when I opened the map, so I didn't look like a twit, but now I've forgotten where I am.
Close the map and open it again. There you go. And right click.
Oh!
Damn it, man, how long have you been playing this game?
I literally didn't know you could do that.
There's no wonder me and you get lost.
Yeah. Well, we usually say that we've forgotten how to ESO, but in this case, I just didn't know how to ESO in the first place. So it's kind of different. There's a waste run over here, apparently.
So are we? Yeah. All right. No need to put. Yeah. So it's just the type of animal. You can get away with just the type of animal that it is. And it's not a Daedric prince either. Or it might, with that enigmatic smile, it possibly could be a Daedric prince in disguise.
I like to believe that.
So, who has win?
Do we have a winner? Ah, they're still going. They're still going. Paul, you on your way back to...
Yeah, handing in after throwing knives at dukes or something. Throwing mud at elves and knives at dukes so far. That's how it's gone.
Sounds like a plan. So let's see.
I think the mud at elves was the best one so far.
Yes, yeah. So you've just done the castle.
That was definitely my favourite as well.
I think the Nord one has to be my favourite. I think that's...
I've not had that one yet. So I've got some of these boxes now, I think. I should open some of those. Oh, they're not in here. Where are they?
Miscellaneous?
Oh, they're miscellaneous.
Yeah.
I've got some new life gift boxes. Hooray. There, I've got a crafting motif. And... Yeah, you get a lot of these. Mud balls. Exciting. And another thing, disposable swallower's sword. Okay.
Yeah, use it.
I should definitely use some of these things, yes. I got a recipe. Okay, so if we go into consumables, we have disposable swallower's sword. Well, that looks pretty horrible.
Well, the lizard should be very, very good at... I don't know, yeah. It's a sort of a snake thing, isn't it? Swallowing everything whole. Lizard's a bit more of a chewer.
Yes, I assume so. I definitely have teeth.
Yeah.
Rather than just fangs. What else do we get in on that? We've got disposable jar. We've seen those. Our mud balls. I've got 20 of those. Can you quick slot these things? Oh, you can. Ooh. There we go. That's presumably. So I have to find some unsuspecting victim.
And we have a winner. Nathan's Plays Game. Congratulations. You're now a rich person.
Save for the house. Save for the house. So we're up to, let's see, we've done the Castle Charm Challenge for the Bretons. We've done the Argonian one for
I need to get to Alakir, and I do not have any way shrines in Alakir. I don't know if you can go to Alakir.
I can take you to Alakir.
That'd be lovely. Otherwise, I'm going to have to do something daft, like find a guildie to port on or walk across lots of things.
Which, whereabouts roughly do you need to be?
I need to be in South Central Alakir.
South
Bergama.
Bergama, let me... I will port to Bergama now, and I will let you know when you can come to me. Well, you can see where I am.
Yes. Lovely.
Awesome stuff. So we're doing, let's see, is this the Red Guard one, the Signal Fire Sprint?
Yes, that's correct.
Yeah, yeah. Have you got much in the way of stamina?
No.
Right.
This is a Magicka Nightblade, and only level 18.
You'll have to run like the wind.
Yes. Oh, do I have? No, I haven't. I've not been to Cyrodiil, so I haven't unlocked that. And, oh, you also get a Major Expedition. So if I cripple things, then I move faster. That's about as good as I can do on this character. I've got Vicious Fidian on my main, which just makes moving fast very lovely. Just keep attacking critters and keep going. How are we doing? Oh, Alakir, there we go. Travel player.
Awesome. So, I mean, going back to Homestead, where are we? Where did we get to? Yeah, I mean, you're not restricted to just one home either. Oh, we should mention as well that when Homestead launches, all the homes that are available will be located in the base zones, not in DLC. So don't worry that if you haven't got DLC, you're going to be restricted to only certain homes. I'm guessing they'll introduce ones with the DLCs. What do we think?
Definitely. Absolutely definitely.
They have said that they will not add any houses in the DLC right now. So you will not have any in Orsinium, Abbas Landing, and the Gold Coast, which is kind of a shame because having a little thief house in Abbas Landing, that could be fun. I would love it. But maybe they will introduce them later. I think they really wanted for the opening of Homestead to be sure that every player could purchase any houses and really enjoy the content, and it will not be gated by a paywall. But in future, we kind of know, because it has been already data mined, that there will be house in Varfandel, and that will be a DLC, obviously. So,
yeah, it would be a shame not to be able to get them in the DLC zones, because obviously the thing is as well is that in the DLC zones in the Gold Coast, most of that is Imperial styled, isn't it?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
So how are they going to get around that?
Well, maybe it will be an Imperial house that you can have even if you're not an Imperial, because it's a DLC, so it's different.
Just have it in that one particular place.
Yeah, but it's not sure at all that they will add houses there, because maybe it's complicated to implement. But in future, they will certainly include house in the new DLC.
So, and also, you can own multiple homes. So if you've got lots and lots of money, you can actually own every single one. You're not restricted to the number of homes that you can own. And all the homes, by the way, are account-based. So once you buy one, every character that you've got has access to that home, or homes if you're an aspiring estate agent. So let's have a see. There are two ways that you can purchase homes in Homestead. Once you've done the tutorial, I believe nearly all the additional homes will be available for purchase via in-game gold. The unfurnished ones that you can purchase for in-game gold are also going to be available for purchase with crowns, apparently.
Mm-hmm. I wonder if for crown you can only purchase the furnished version or also the unfurnished version.
Yeah. Yeah.
But what's very interesting is that to be able to purchase a home, you firstly need to do some achievements. It's probably not complicated achievement. Maybe it's just to have done all the quests of the zone or to have explored everything. But it's nice that you are kind of forced to complete the game to be able to purchase your home. So if you have never been in Reaper's Marsh, for instance, you cannot just get the Khajiit home. You need to firstly explore the zone or do the quest or whatever they have decided. Yeah. We do not know yet.
Yeah, it's sort of like grinding reputation, isn't it? You're going to have to raise a certain... I'm guessing you're going to have to raise a certain amount of rep with... in whatever zone that you wish to purchase a home in before you can actually purchase the home. That seems to me is the how it's going to go. I mean, Nate, have you got a favourite area where you're going to
set up? Well, yeah, I mean, I'm a big fan of the wood elves in general, so anything wood elfish is probably where I'm going to want to have a house. To stick to the law with Misa being an Imperial, I'm definitely going to have an Imperial house as well. And as I said earlier, you know, any future chance of there being any kind of Dwemer dungeon type housing, it's going to be a case of shut up and take my money.
yes.
Yeah. But at least to begin with, we'll have something Wood Elf, something, you know, something Bosmer, and something Imperial to begin with, I think.
I mean, how are you off on the sort of the crafting side of things?
I'm a master crafter, so I'm maxed out on everything, so that's no problem. I can craft anything in almost any style, so that's fine, which goes out to the guild. If anyone ever needs anything crafting, then just let me know.
Awesome stuff.
So, yeah, so I don't think that's a problem. And that's something that's very exciting as well. And I know that in conversations with a Jealous as well on Tales, you know, being able to craft stuff and sell stuff that we craft is very exciting. I think they've said there's about 2,000 items that can be crafted, which is going to be everything, I think, from, you know, very small things on walls to, you know, very large furniture and everything in between in a range of styles, which is great. As I think was mentioned earlier on the show today, the engine is meant to be very comprehensive. And, you know, if you want to have an upside down chair somewhere in the room, you can. If you want to have, you know, the horns of your elk poking through a door, that should also be fine. So that's very, very exciting. I'm still slightly apprehensive about, you know, the law side of this, in that, you know, there'll be a lot of people hanging outside the same house as they enter, and so it won't really feel like my house. But I think that's kind of unavoidable, I suppose. I was hoping there might be more like 400 houses rather than 40, or at least 400 locations for houses. But still, there's a lot to be excited.
It's a good start. There Definitely. Will be more later. Yeah. What's also very nice that all craft will be implicated in this system, so you will have cooking also that you to create food that you can place in your table and such, and also the combination of different crafts. And so certain furniture will require you to use blacksmithing, clothing, and woodworker in the same times, and that will be interesting. It encourage again players to play the game to craft better. And some crafter will be able to make forge, even if you don't like housing or you don't care, you just want to earn money, you just use your crafter to sell chair and such to people. It can be, I think in this update, there's a lot of people, well, not a lot, but certain person where saying that it was no new content, but it is new content, and there is something for everyone, almost. Maybe not PvPer, but
yeah,
crafter, achiever, collector, people that enjoy house, role player, that would be a paradise for them.
Yeah, it's a big system to add to the game.
Yeah,
it really is. Yeah, and I mean, it's been massively successful in other games. I mean, going back to the crafting thing, in other games, crafting housing items was almost a profession in itself. You could make oodles of in-game gold from simply crafting housing items. I mean, have you, Nate, encountered that sort of thing in any other MMOs or?
Well, I mean, I suppose the closest really is was in Skyrim. you know, with Hearthfire.
Yes. Yeah.
That was just wonderful. I mean, even before that expansion came out. By the way, am I thinking right? It is Hearthfire, right?
It is Hearthfire. Yeah.
I always get confused with Hearthstone. So, you know, I mean, I was basically making my houses in that game. I mean, I spent hours and hours manually placing stuff just in the houses with the existing base game system in those games. I mean, I remember once spending at least an entire night effectively moving house, which is, you know, load up your maximum capacity on your character, porting to your new house, placing all the items, and then porting back to fill up your bag again and moving back. And that was kind of, I don't think I'm alone in that. I'm sure there are a lot of people listening or watching who did that as well. And it was just because it was such a fun thing to do in a game. And if it's even remotely like that, at least in terms of the flexibility of placing objects, then that is going to be very, very exciting to me, I think. And I know, and then as a comparison in Final Fantasy 14, I think is a decent housing system as well, in some ways, which I think is good. I wouldn't want to have exactly the same system in ESO, but there's a lot that they could learn, I think, from Final Fantasy 14.
I think the system would be quite similar in terms of you purchase your house, then there are instances you can invite everyone, you can place your object the way you want. It seems to be quite similar. The only difference with Wildstar, which also had a very, very good housing system, is that you cannot scale things. But Wildstar is a... it's not a serious game like ESO.
No.
So it's okay that they do not allow rescaling. I completely understand. It will be too crazy.
Yeah.
I'm looking forward to guild events in people's homes. You know, that's going to be that's going to be a lot of fun. And for, you know, for any RP players, you know, that's going to be a whole new breath of life. I mean, a lot of the dungeons are going to sort of empty overnight as people move a lot of that RP into their homes. I think, you know, I do a little bit of that, and less so these days. But you know, just in terms of pure having a guild meeting and having everyone do slash sit chair around your table is just going to be a huge amount of fun.
Yeah, it's true.
Yeah,
and you can really make a guild house too if you really want. You have like, I don't know, one person in the guild, like the guild leader. I'm a guild leader in my other, well, whatever. You get all the money, you buy the house, and then you set the permission so every guildie can decorate it, and then ta-da, it becomes a guild house. And everyone can collaborate to it. So.
And hopefully in the future, there will be guild halls. Surely.
Maybe they will do that.
Yeah.
But
meanwhile, if it's not in the system, you can make your guild hall. Because, like I say, you just the permission are there, so you can really do it. It's not officially guild hall, but if you gather the money, you purchase the big mansion in Glenumbra, for instance, this huge castle, and then it become officially the guild hall, paid by every member for the guild. Every member got their permission to decorate, and that's it.
That's right. Guild hall. Because you can add permissions. Based on either from your friends list or from your guild as well. So
one of the things that I hope is possible, and I don't know if this has been explained yet, but it kind of goes back to my obsession with in-game lore books, which is I want to be able to go around to somebody else's house, browse their bookshelf, and think, ooh, I haven't read A Brief History of the Empire for a while. I'll read this now, and just take the book off their shelf and give it a read.
Yeah. Can you imagine that, though? I mean,
I can imagine it.
Anyway. Yeah. Really good.
I'm imagining it right now. Good
collection. Yeah, let's go over to Nate's house. He's got all those books. You know, you come home from a hard day's adventuring, and there's 30 people stood in your house reading
my books. I know. That would be wonderful. By the way, as a slight side note, I just was collecting this Stone Tooth mystery meat as part of the New Life Festival. And I was thinking, it's not really that much of a mystery, is it? I just killed a wolf to get it.
Yeah.
I mean, it's wolf meat. It's not a mystery. Anyway, sorry.
So let's have a look. So where did we get to with Homestead? I mean, I think we've pretty much wrapped up Homestead, haven't we? Paul, whereabouts are you at the moment?
I am jumping off of things.
Ah.
And getting set. And this feels like an appropriate Alithian activity.
Yeah.
It's very good. It is actually one of my favourites, is that? Because, I mean, you jump off into the water. When you get out of the water, wherever you jump off, there's a nearby bonfire where various Nards are stood around partying in various states of undress. And you actually stand there shivering until you actually warm up. So,
yeah. It's really well made. And if you undress completely and you do all the jump undressed, perfectly undressed, you get an achievement.
Oh, I didn't know that.
Now you know.
Oh, that's
me doing
that. Yeah, that's me doing that next time I do it.
Do I have to take my jewelry off?
That's a good point.
I've got a costume, so I need to
uncostume. Yeah.
Uncostume as well.
What do we need to get undressed for, sorry?
That would scale
to see the Nord one.
Yeah. Oh, I haven't done that.
Yeah, now I want to see how awesome my Argonian really looks.
Well,
wow, it's going to be some naked Misa. This is disconcerting.
That's going to be a little more not safe for work than the naked watched by many, I feel.
Mm.
You are actually being watched by many as well. It's quite an appropriate name. We've got a pharaoh selection of people in chat at the moment. So,
it wasn't named streaming. It was just named on the grounds that in an MMO, the hero of an MMO is watched by many other players. That was where it came from.
This is true.
But it's quite appropriate right now. Here we go then.
Whee! And there we go. So, closing thoughts on Homestead.
Can't wait. Bring it now. The end.
And it's the bookshelves and the books, obviously. You've sort of intimated that's the bookshelf and the books. You said that you were interested in the Bosma. Are you interested in the island, by the way?
Not really, but it depends how much it costs. I don't feel that I want an island in life, so I don't think I want one in the game.
Yeah. That's very deep.
There are lots of things I don't want in life that I do want in game. Like a staff that shoots fireballs. I'm pretty sure I should not be trusted with one of those in real life, but I definitely want one in game.
So, Elloa, where are you going to set up home?
I'm not sure. It will depend on this island in the Crown Star. Kind of curious about that one. I may let myself tempted by that. Otherwise, I don't know, maybe a gadget house or something.
Yeah. I don't know. How much do we think it's going to cost?
That's probably a lot. Probably more than 5,000 crown.
What's been the most expensive? Is it 5,000 crowns is pretty much the most expensive thing?
Yes, this would be more than that. It would be 6,000 or something. Yeah. It would be something crazy. Something you say, do I buy it? Yeah.
4,000 odd for a hat rack is pretty expensive, isn't it? But I'm still gonna buy the mobile hat rack. So myself, do you know, I haven't a clue. I always think back. I'm just going to sit with the in-room, I think, for a while, because I remember buying an expansion for... Bella actually mentioned the housing system in EverQuest 2. And I bought one of the expansions, and you got a huge house in one of the major cities with one of the expansions. And I remember that house having a table and a chair and a candle in it for months and months without me actually decorating it at all. So, yeah, I'm probably going to stick with an in-room somewhere.
Was it in-room, really?
In-room, yeah. Until it gets too crowded.
Oh.
Which is going to be hard for me, you see, because I suffer from clutter blindness. If I can't see it, you know, that pile of rubbish on my desk, it doesn't exist. I tied my desk when I can't actually physically type anymore. and then I have to tidy up. So yeah, an in room for me, I think. So so I reckon we can do another giveaway.
Should we give some more money?
I think we might give some more money away. Who has the next word?
Well, as Paul is very concentrated, I guess I will give it away again.
Go for it.
So, guys, be attentive and listen carefully. I want you to give the name of the NPC that gave the quest for the New Life event. What is her name? Zenimax have also made an article about her. So, it should not be too hard to guess it.
This is terrible. I desperately want you to say, listen very carefully, I will say this only once. Wonderful accent you've got. Did you ever see the program that I'm referring to? It was an English television program called... What was it called? Damn. Hello. It was called Hello. It was actually set in France during World War II. But there was a famous catchphrase. So, yeah. There. I'll shut up because I'm embarrassing myself now. As to how I actually am, to remember that one.
Yeah, there was a joke of the person that couldn't speak French who sort of just spoke English in a really bad French accent.
Yes, there was a policeman who was... Yeah, it was an Englishman undercover pretending to be a French policeman with an absolutely hilariously atrocious French accent.
Which is why Chris thinks it would be amusing for you to say this in your beautiful Belgian accent.
That wasn't the policeman that used to say this, that though.
Okay. I'm not up to speed.
Wasn't the policeman. No.
I'm only 26. I'm not up to speed on all this retro stuff. Sorry about that.
It is pretty retro as well, yeah. I mean, we're talking 1980s? 90s?
90s.
Like that. 90s, yes.
I was alone. 90s. The 90s were a thing.
I remember the 90s pretty well.
Yeah, me too.
Yeah, I was an 80s person, I must admit. I was, yeah. With the hair. When I had hair. I had hair then.
Oh, that's not what I want to go to.
That's on my head, not on my skin. How are we doing in chat?
There's a lot of people that have tempted their luck and find a good answer. So, crossing my finger for you guys. May the best of you get the money.
So, second time giveaway. And rolling now. Keep your fingers crossed. Rama apparently sticking with Bob, because that will be the correct answer as we go through the various things.
We need to make an add-on that renames every NPC to Bob.
Bob. And we have a winner.
Zarok, congratulations.
Congratulations. There we go. That's another 20k in donation towards someone's house. Awesome stuff. So, let's have a see. Whereabouts are you now, Paul?
I have just eventually managed to get to Betnik, which took me a while because I didn't have a way shrine here. So I went to Daggerfall and took the boat, but then I took the boat to the wrong place because the boat offers lots of places, apparently. but I'm in Betnik, which is kind of orky and cool.
Awesome stuff. And, so I think...
I don't know what this is going to be about.
It involves, killing... things.
Mystery meat. That's the mystery meat.
Yes.
Oh, right.
Not so much a mystery as...
The not so mystery meat.
The not so mystery. Yeah. Fortunately, it doesn't make you vomit when you pick it up like the usual sack of mystery meat does.
Oh, yeah. I remember that quest. unidentified meat or something. Yeah,
it's something like that. Yeah, sack of mystery. I think it's actually sack of mystery meat, isn't it?
Is it?
I think it's, yeah, sack of mystery meat.
Yeah, I think I've got that. Hang on.
It's in the collectibles.
I think that's right.
Yeah.
Questionable meat sack.
That's the one. Questionable meat sack. Yeah, but then it leaves. What it leaves on the ground is called mystery meat.
That's right, yeah.
And then if you use it, or if someone else uses it,
instantly turn green.
I believe that it comes from the quest in Dashan with the cannibals.
It does, yeah.
Yeah.
We realize he's eating... They're eating each other to stay alive in that dungeon.
Yeah, exactly.
I quite liked that quest, actually. It was dark and weird.
It was suitably done merry, I felt. Mm.
Yes.
As opposed to Bosmeri.
I was going to say the Bosmeri with their meat mandates. I think it's similar. I think the difference is with the Bosmer, they were dead before they were destined to be food.
This is true. There's a little bit of a distinction there.
Mm.
So, Paul, I don't know whether you want to sort of pause for... What we'll do is we'll go on to guild news.
Ah, yes. Excellent. Yes. Okay, hang on. Let me do that. So you can all see my ugly mug again.
Awesome.
Right. So, yes. We have... done the guild awards. So the officers, of whom only one is currently represented here. I pointed the wrong way. It's that way. You're over there.
That's it.
We only have one officer here. But yes, we have, the officers have come up with awards. And there's also members awards. So which way should we going to do this? We're going to do this. We'll start with the guild champion.
Start with the guild champion, yeah. Yeah.
So rather excitingly, our guild champion is our newest PvP raid leader, Rainbow Zod, who is just always trying to drag people into PvP, having loads of fun, just really casual and very Alithian and wearing bright colours and spitting camels at everybody. And generally adding lots of value to the guild. So big congratulations to Rainbow.
Well done. It's very well deserved.
You are our guild champion.
Congratulations. Good stuff.
Congrats.
Congratulations.
So.
So are you going to do above and beyond, Chris?
Yes. I'll go through above and beyond. This, again, is awarded by the officers. Basically, it's given to any members for any sort of general positive actions that have stood out to us. It can be anything from helping out a fellow guildmate in need to or coming up with a new idea for the guild or for a guild event. We actually pick these out randomly at any point. It's not just sort of, you know, at one sort of stage where we're looking for the above and beyond. Anything that sort of like stands out to us, we'll make a note of for when the above and beyond comes around next time. And we should mention, here's our list. Claire Ella, who is not with us anymore, she used to be an officer. She did outstanding work, and she continues to be an excellent member of the guild. We have Gothic. Fu was here. And Cygnus. Sods. Caroline Yu. Maxime, Mr. Redhead. Nefin. Styx, 2187. Zenshi Rahiko, which is wrong. Andoza, 75. Geraint Ambrosia. Elloa. Congratulations. Lonin, Mip, Aldin, Alan, 3136, Raniana, Nix Payne, Trimhilda, And Seraph, congratulations. You are our Above and Beyond member for this time round. Well done.
Yay. And now it's time to congratulate the members champion. So this award is voted by the members for the members. Each month, Elite members vote for who they would like to see recognized for their good deeds and general positive contribution to the guild. So we have Unsignus, Fu Was Here, Rainbow Zods, Aspel11, Maxim, Karnak, QB, Fragtem, Zods, Caroline U, Ranyana, Davy Wavy, Vlad Belial, Zenshiru, Zenshi, Ryuko, Jaren Ambrosia, Meep, Annie Bigut, Kinmon17, Bridget Silverbow, Valmac, and Mr. Redhead. Congratulations, guys.
Well done, guys. Yeah, congratulations. And that is peer voted. You've been voted by your fellow guild. Got out of English momentarily. First time today. I'm doing quite well. Voted by your fellow guild mates. Very well done. So,
now we have the party animals.
Yes.
So these are for fun-loving, positive members in the guild. And this is voted for both by members and officers. And this is for people that help with the general atmosphere of the guild by being fun, social, and all-round crazy. And in this category, we have Unsignus, Fu Was Here, Wolf Kex, Spit X, Styx2187, Marcus Raider, Cedras, Caroline U, Karnag, Dimaskinos, Gothic, Loxias Hircle.
You're doing well.
Argonianish, I think. Era, Zenshi, Andoza, and Davy.
Congrats, guys. Yay.
And now time to congratulate the event champions, awarded to all those members who are victorious in any of our official guild events. Well done, and look forward to seeing you at our next guild event. Himhild, Berish, Unsignus, Ranyana, Fu Was Here, Is Everywhere, Rainbow Zod, Holy Witch Girl, 2187, Nathan, Direwolf 8, The Era, Mr. Redhead, Pema, Sots, Gothic, Bad Girlfan, and Wolf Kex.
Congratulations, yes, our guild event winners.
Yay.
So, and of course, we have a special category, which is a special mention to all of our newly promoted senior members. Big thank you for sticking with us. These are guys who have been active members for 6 months or more. So we've got quite a list. It's not as massive a list as we have had. We've had to have people take multiple stabs at pronouncing all these words, but I'll give it my best shot. So from the top, we have Sincaris, Wolfkex, Ainthel, Artask, Zenshi. I'm going to go with Niaty because it's N180Y. Apologies if I've just butchered that. Livy Locke, Luxovius, Theatres, Marken, Cygnus, Dinoslav, Is Elder, Verush, Vakilks. I'm going to hazard a guess at that one. Jongo 36, possibly Greydust, Creasy, Zagon Kratos, Legaska, Oddipop, Tadus Demus, Corlagon, Xenex. I'll stick at Xenex. Apologies if I've just ruined that completely. Nelia, Sev, Deathlust, Colonial, Isander, Buzz 2020, Judas M, Caroline U, Hayden, Eru, Papa, EMD Kiwi, Ryluk 1204, Covert, Jola Rosa, Elvis Sinatra, who apparently has not left the building yet. sorry. Veins, Ilvilja, Foo the Worm. We have another Foo in the guild. Wow.
it's so fun.
Yeah. Pask, Birgit Silverbow, Rudolph 87, Chloris, Nocturus, Styx, Battle of Bywater, and Mr. Monster 66. Thank you for staying with us for more than 6 months, being active members. Awesome stuff. So, so we should mention as well now that the other guild news is that we've got some upcoming vacancies. We're still recruiting for recruitments. Yeah, we're recruiting recruiters to recruit for us. So we're still recruiting for recruitment champions. He said, achieving the... Do I get an achievement for that? The most use of the word recruit in a sentence. We're recruiting for... I'm repeating myself now. We're recruiting for recruitment champions. Keep your eyes on the forum. And more excitingly, we're going to be recruiting for two new officers very, very soon. So if you want to add value to the guild and come and help us out, it's not an unpleasant job, I do have to say. It's a very, very pleasant job. Paul, you can attest to that fact. It's a pleasant job, isn't it?
It is a real pleasure. Yeah.
It's
hard
great
work, job. But it's a really wonderful thing to do. Absolutely. It's
good stuff. Yes, yeah, so yeah, keep your eye on the forums. There will be two posts going up for new officers very, very soon. So, let's have a see. Do we do another giveaway? Whereabouts are you at the moment, mate?
I'm still on Betnik, where I was a minute ago.
Ah, right.
I don't know whether we want to follow through with this commitment to do all nine. I have
to do all nine. How many more have you got to do? Oh, let's have a see.
This is a question. Holiday events, New Life Festival.
We know you've done Castle Chat. We know you've done Fishbone Feast.
Which is the one that will show me all the things. Complete all the doodahs. I appear to have done six, so I'm on number seven.
Six. So seven of nine. So what do I reckon? Do we think we're going to get through... Ooh.
A very subtle Star Trek reference then.
Seven of nine, yes. Yes, I missed that one.
That's lost on me, I'm afraid. I have no idea what you're on about. Seven of nine, and I'm now naked. So that's, you know, we're all going in the right direction.
Naked seven of nine, Jerry.
I managed to do that Nord one without taking my clothes off.
Sorry.
Yeah, you can do it, but you don't have the achievement then.
Oh!
Yeah.
Is that really? Oh, okay.
Yeah, I'm definitely for the next one. The next time I do that particular quest.
Do I have to wait till tomorrow then to do that?
Yeah,
if you've done it today, yes. Yeah.
Oh dear.
Where do I get the not so mystery meat?
Wolves, basically.
So it's really wolf meat. That's the mystery.
Yeah, that's the mystery. It's the wolf meat. It is. So, what else have we got on the agenda? I don't think we've actually got anything else on the agenda. We sort of need to twiddle our thumbs and talk randomly about stuff.
That's pretty much always what the whole agenda is, isn't it?
The whole agenda. Yeah. Shall we give some more money away? That's usually quite popular.
That's generally a popular activity, isn't it? Giving money away. We're running out of content. Give money away.
Yeah, give money away quick. Keep them entertained while we think of something else to talk about. Go on, Elloa. Give them some more money.
Yeah, sure. Yes. Let me check the thing. Okay, so there's a new word to discover. It's very, very hard. If you want to earn 20,000 gold, not crown, gold, you need to find the name of this seasonal event. How it's called, it's in two words.
There we go. And I instantly look at chat, which I do every single time. And I know I'm quite aware that I actually say this every single time. I look at chat and realize that it's a 15-second delay. So what have we been? I'm going to shamelessly Bob contact. I'm going to shamelessly rob content from Agelus and Arcaneer and say, what have we been getting up to in the game just recently? Apart from your life and thinking about Homestead.
And being a naked lizard.
And being a naked lizard, yes. Yes, we know what you've been up to.
it's all the things to do in ESO right now. I mean, we can do the dungeon and Craglorn and PvP later. It's time to enjoy this festive moment. It's a bit more casual, it's a bit more funny, but it's the right time to do it. Everyone is also busy in real life with their family and friends and such. So it's perfect time for having a bit more light gameplay.
It is, yes. Yeah. Nate, what have you been up to?
Well, I spent 3 weeks not in the game, thanks to a ridiculous schedule in my regular meat space life. But one thing I did do, aside from PvP, is I found a quest, a regular original quest in Shadowfen that I've never done. And I found it this evening while doing the new life stuff. So that is a little treat, a bonus. Admittedly, it was finding the remains of somebody's mother, but still, yeah. I hadn't done it. It was new. I got some experience and I got to talk to an Argonian. Which is all good in my book, in my lore book. Nice. So that is about it. Also getting a lot of my items that I had to sell with guild traders returned to me unsold. So I now need to do some serious Skyrim-style inventory management to sort that out.
That happens to me quite a lot.
And then, but what I'm planning on doing is finishing going through Craglorn. So my brother, who also plays, is going to be here with me in the flesh over the next couple of weeks. And we're going to go through and do all of Craglorn over the festive period. So it's not so much what I have done as what I'm planning on doing over the next week or so. But that is on the agenda. We've got mead and we've got various teas, so it's going to be a lot of fun. Really looking forward to it.
Cool stuff. Yeah, awesome stuff. Yeah, I mean, what have I been doing? I haven't been doing huge amounts in the game. I've been looking forward to New Life Festival, and I've been logging in regularly to do that. I actually started off New Alt, which is not unusual for me, being a confirmed Altaholic. Just been sort of steadily. The thing that I find so nice now is that with One Tamriel is that you can just relax.
Mm-hmm.
As I've noticed that, there's the urgency to do things has gone, but not in a bad way, if this makes any sense.
Yeah, it totally makes sense.
Yeah, for me, it was sort of like level, and skip quests and get this done, get that done, get to Cold Harbor and then start earning champion points. Whereas now the this lack of urgency now, where you can sort of like relax and know that it doesn't matter where you are in the game, everything that you do counts towards your progress.
Yeah.
And, I love that change.
Which is fantastic. The change is brilliant. Yeah.
This change is amazing. There's so much good review, good feedback about it. There's MMORPG, massively overpowered, that's rewarded the Elder Scrolls Online for the best improvement of 2016.
Yeah.
And all the comments were related to One Tamriel. One Tamriel is what ESO should have been at release. They could have not done it, but it is how it is now, and that's great. So right now, it's all that matter anyway, so just let's enjoy ESO.
It is, yeah. Yeah, it's been fantastic for me as that. So, where are we up to, Paul?
I just had to burp at someone as an optional objective.
Ah, right. Yes. Yeah.
That's a sentence I wasn't expecting to say this evening.
That's a good one.
Should try growing up in Derbyshire.
But I'm from Yorkshire, so I have equal sympathies with you, I must admit.
Well, I was born in Yorkshire, actually. So.
Really? Yes.
Yeah, in Rotherham.
Ah, Rotherham. Yes, I was born in Acworth. A little bit farther up. Yes, Rotherham's south Yorkshire.
South, you're north, south. Yeah.
Yes, yeah, we're west Yorkshire.
West.
Yeah, yeah. So, yeah, somewhere in between Doncaster and Wakefield, Acworth.
Know the area as well.
Yes. So, yeah, so, yeah. Festive burping, yeah.
But festive burping, that reminds me of a daily quest you can do in ESO right now.
The one thing, the thing that amused me about the, about when you actually, it's called showing your appreciation to another player. And your character actually goes and wipes his mouth from all the food and goes, and then flourishes while he belches at another player. So I quite like that, though. That tickled me, did that one, I must admit.
So, sorry to interrupt this nice story, but we need to congratulate Kinai Life. Kinian J Life. Congratulations. Yay.
Oh, King Life. Yes. Excellent. Well done.
Oh, it's King Life, sorry.
Good stuff. Yes, we have our third and final winner. Yes, two Yorkshiremen. Well, yeah, two Yorkshiremen. We should be doing the Monty Python sketch, shouldn't we? Yeah, yeah. You were lucky. When I was a lad, we used to live in an hole at Middlet Road. Yeah.
And we liked it.
And we liked it, yes. Yes. So, have we any questions from chat about the various things that we've... what is everybody looking forward to? Or what has everybody enjoyed about New Life? This is good content, this is cheating. This we get to make everyone else make content for us. Go on. Craft content. Want to buy more content while Paul does the rest of these quests. Yeah, it's for Yorkshiremen, I believe. Yeah, we're lacking in Yorkshiremen for the full sketch.
Oh no, I have to do lock picking on live stream.
No pressure.
That's worse than in a group. Oh, that one was all right. I've done that one.
Is that the
they go up to one? Yeah, one of them goes up to advanced. Yeah.
Yeah, and you've got to do them in a certain amount of time as well. I went for a bio break between doing two of them, and came back down to find that I'd failed miserably because you've only got a certain amount of time. Is a hole in the middle of the road a homestead option? Well, there we go. Yeah.
Great question.
Email community at elderscrollsonline.com, and you can always ask. So how many people can we have invited to our home?
It's 24, I think.
Is it 24 max? Yeah.
It's 24 max right now. Some of the smaller ones are less. I think they're 12.
Yeah.
But they're not all 24, but they're no larger than 24 yet.
Right.
So I think one of the requests was to have the guild hall. So you could have, 100 guildies all in the same hall. Yeah. But that's not something that's going to be there at launch, at least.
Yeah. Right. Yeah, because it's going to be, buying the island, the huge island, and then only 24 concurrent people to be in it is going to be restrictive.
Yeah.
Yeah,
but if you're the kind of person that wants an island, do you really want 24 people on it? Do you not buy an island to have only one?
One and a man Friday, yeah.
But it's nice that they are not giving any advantages to the Kron store property, so it's just fancier or different.
Yes. Yeah.
If you want that one island or that whatever they are going to do, you can have it, but it's just for yourself. It's not anything advantageous over other players.
I believe the island's coming late. It's not launching with Homestead, is it? Or is
yes,
it?
I think they start with that one, but there's other coming. So I do not know. Will I save my Kron to choose which property I want? In case they bring something even better after, or that I prefer, that fit me better, Or will I be impatient? Yeah, we don't know.
Do you buy the island and suddenly find out that there's a castle?
Yeah, or something, you know. Never know what can come.
This is it.
I think you'll have to assume that with anything else in Elder Scrolls, there'll be something good to begin with, but there's always going to be something better down the road. So, you know, I kind of think it's sort of like buying a computer. You just buy the best at whatever it is when you get it, because there'll always be something better in like a week's time. Mm-hmm. So I wouldn't worry too much. Well, personally, I'm not going to worry too much about it. I'm just going to buy what I like at the time.
Yeah.
I am very tempted by the island, I must admit. Yeah.
It depends.
I see. You will not stay inside your in room.
Just for the sake of having an island.
I think it'll be quite expensive. I mean, look, if you look at the increasing cost of mounts, I mean, we're up to 4,500 crowns now for an elk.
Yes.
I think if it's 4,500 for an elk, you know, generally in my experience, islands cost more than elks. So I think it will be quite expensive. I'm just going to throw that out there. I think I'm expecting expensive.
Yeah. Yeah, I think we'd... let's see. I mean, the crown packs, the largest crown pack is
5,500.
Yes. So it'd be interesting to see if they go above 5,500.
I think they will. If I had to guess... I have no knowledge about this, but I'm guessing if the island was less than 10,000 crowns, I would be surprised.
Really? Oh, wow. 10,000 crowns.
Yeah, I honestly think it will be, because it's not like a mount. You know, it's one big thing to have. It's one big flashy blowout. And I think if you're already looking at 4,500 crowns for just another mount, admittedly a nice one with fantastic antlers, class leading antlers. Class-leading antlers. You've got to be talking more than that for an island, because it's got to feel exclusive, and the exclusivity will come from the cost, I think. So that's just my guess. Prove me wrong, but it's my guess.
Definitely one to watch. Yeah, I mean, the antlers are a bit OP, aren't they?
Well, the annoying thing is when you hit spacebar, I mean, camels spit. Yeah. And some of the other ones roar and whatever. All this does is kind of rear onto its hind legs and kind of do a little thing with his antlers. For the benefit of everyone listening and not watching, I'm doing a little thing with my hands. Human hooves, as I like to call them. It really would have been better if it had done something with the antlers.
Yeah, it would. Yes, I was wondering what it actually did. Hey, yeah.
Yeah, a bit disappointed with that.
It rears up and paws at the air with hooves. Hooves at the air. Yeah. So have we any other questions? About ESO. We have one question in chat, but that we could go on for hours and hours and hours answering that particular question. Let's have a see. I don't think we have. Come on, guys. We've got lots of speculation about how much it's going to, how much it's actually going to cost. 10,000 crowns is pretty much 40 to 45 quid. Yeah.
It's pretty expensive for a virtual.
Pretty expensive. Villain. Yeah.
I'm going to say pretty ridiculous, frankly. 40
to 45 quid. Yeah. That's a
pretty ridiculous.
That's the price of the game. What's the game at the moment?
Less than that.
Less than that.
Depends. Where you buy it from, because I think it was on sale on Steam the other day, wasn't it?
Yeah. It was. Yeah. Yeah, it was sometimes £16.95 or something like that. It's actually been less, hasn't it, on Steam?
Yeah.
I think it's been down as low as sort of £10.
So it's really if you want to support the game and offer yourself something nice in the game. It's a bit crazy, but well, they need to earn their money somewhere, I guess.
I can see that glint in your eye that suggests you might just blow on it and just go for it.
Just go for it, yeah. Why not?
I'm definitely not going to. I mean, that's just crazy. I'm not going to have a house, I think, is what's going to happen, because I will never have enough crowns. I mean, I get the ESO Plus subscription crowns, and I'm always so poor in in-game gold that there's just no way I'll ever get. I'll be in that in-room with Chris.
Bunk beds. Yeah.
Unless I can be a Telvanni wizard and live in a mushroom house, then I have to make an exception. But
this is true. Yes. Yeah. Definitely want the mushroom house. So, yeah. So I think that pretty much wraps it up. I don't think we're going to manage the old nine. The old nine.
No. I'm on nine of nine. I've just discovered that I am in the wrong town, which is kind of
Oh, damn it.
But I've got 88 gold. I'm not totally poor, so I can port.
I can help you port if you need to port somewhere.
No, I'm good, actually. I think I'm now in the right place. I don't know how long this quest is. This really is. This is nine of nine.
Oh, you're on the the Firefoot Stomp, is it?
Yes.
Yeah, the Dawn. Yeah.
Dance, apparently. That's right, pretty similar to the perform one where I threw knives at a duke.
It is pretty much, yeah, yes, it is. So, yeah, so I think we're going to, pretty much wrap it up for this evening, unfortunately.
Yep.
So, massive thank you to everyone who is who joined us on Twitch this evening. It's really, really appreciated. Every single person in chat, thank you very, very much for joining us. It's been an absolute pleasure. And a big thank you to Nate
for being Thank you, man. No, it's been great being here. A lot of fun. Been wanting to do this for some time. And what better time than the end of the year to unlock that achievement.
That particular achievement, yes. Yeah. Yeah, I mean, so what I should do is give you a chance to plug yourself where you can be got in touch with and, you know.
Yeah. Well, the best thing, I mean, in game, I'm at, what am I? Lanxon 101. LAN. I should know that by now. I've been playing the game for 3 years on one account. Lanxon 101. So LANXON 101. You can add me. I'm always happy. In particular, I do a lot of PvP. So if you need someone to hold your hand during PvP, then always happy to do that. Obviously, we're an Ebonheart Pact. And you can always message me on Twitter at Nate ESO is my Elder Scrolls focused Twitter account. And I do a tech podcast. If any of you are very hungry for technology stuff, I have a technology podcast called Text Message, which is popular if you're a massive tech nerd. So check it out if you fancy that.
Fantastic. Okie dokie, right. Yeah, it's an absolute pleasure having you on the show, mate. And welcome back anytime, obviously.
Thank you very much.
Look forward to any more, mate. Definitely.
Thank you.
So, yes, and big thank you to Ellen for joining you.
Of course.
And to Paul for providing the background music, as it were, albeit visually.
Yes. I've just been told to go to Ebonheart because apparently there's a whole load of guildies waiting to do something to me. So I assume I'm going to get mudballed from every direction.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Something of that general nature.
Yes. The interactive star of the show. We should make it more interactive, really. We should be able to get chats to tell you where to go and what to do. That would be entertaining. Although I get the feeling it involved leaping off cliffs and taking one's clothes off quite a lot, given... Give Nailith's reputation.
I can definitely see.
You've been pelted by multiple
ladders, please. Oh, here it is, the mud. Oh.
Yeah.
So, yes, and massive thank you, as always, to our fantastic Aelith team, the officers, raid leaders, and recruitment champions for the huge amount of hard work that you put in every single day. If you're interested in joining Aelith, you can head over to our website at www.alitheso.com, register and fill out an application form, and we'll get back to you as soon as we can. You can also find us on Facebook if you search for Alith ESO. We have a group on Facebook where you can see us doing relatively normal things. I say relatively, yeah, because normal is sort of relative. If you're listening to this on YouTube, we have a YouTube channel under Alith-Cast. Please subscribe and hit that like button. You know what to do. You can do that. We have had the occasion. We knew we'd hit it on YouTube. We'd hit the big time on YouTube when we started getting dislikes. Yeah. You know you've made it on YouTube when you get dislikes, definitely. We've annoyed someone, we've achieved something. So the podcast version of the show is available to listen to and to download from iTunes, podbean.com, where you can listen to it and download it, and via the Podbean app, which is a free app. For all of you out there who are currently watching us on Twitch, please hit that follow button. Every single follow means a huge amount to us. If you're listening to us on the podcast, or if you're watching us on YouTube, that if you search for Aliths ESO on Twitch, go there, follow us there. It's most appreciated. We have an official guild Twitter feed at Aliths ESO. You can follow us on there. I encourage guild members to follow us on there, because there are regular guild updates on there. The various raids that we have every day, that all gets pushed out to there with various news items. And for everything else, you're quite welcome to email us at info@alithesso.com. And you can contact us in-game. We're quite happy to chat to you in-game. And there will be a list of officers displayed on screen at the moment. And I'm, damn it, pointing in the wrong direction again. It's down there. Every time. I'm going to get a stick. Excuse me. I'm going to get a sticker put on my monitor that says, point in this direction. So, let's have a see. Yes. Huge, big thank you to my fellow presenters, and most importantly of all, to the members of Aelith for making it an absolute pleasure to log in every single day. Yeah, means a lot to us, guys. Well done. Thanks very much. And that wraps it up for tonight. So,
and very happy holidays to everyone. Merry Indeed. Christmas. Happy whatever you're celebrating, and a very, very nice Happy New Year.
Yeah.
Awesome stuff. 2017 will be very exciting. You will see.
Oh, yes. Lots to do. Excellent stuff. Good night, everybody.
Bye, guys.
Bye.
Bye-bye.